So what are you free? Andrew McCart, IFL TV in association with MTK Global. Well, Sean McComb, a minute and a bit in the first round. Talk me through it.
I'm exhausted. Absolutely exhausted. tough 1 minute there. In all honesty, it was a good fight for me. Obviously, a good step up, apparently, anyway. And I dealt with it well, calm, cool, calm, and collective. Before the fight, I was very calm. All day, I was very calm. All week, I knew the opponent, and he was a tough operator. But I knew he was going to bring the best of me out, and that's exactly what happened early.
Was that the game plan? Going out there and putting on from the start?
Not at all. I just found my range early. Was able to get hit or able to hit and not get hit early on without actually moving. So I found my range and I believe I landed. Danny and Dom were working on the left hand of the body and at the feet early on just to see what reaction we get, and it landed clean, and from then he couldn't recover and it just opened up with a 40 punch combination.
Did you make a statement tonight then?
That's it, statement was made, and there's a new super lightweight on the scene. So Sam Maxwell from McKenna, there's only one super lightweight in the gym now. Don't be scared of your last fight.
Tyrone McKenna might start crying, you better not take that title off him. So what's next for you then? I mean, you're stepping up, and you keep producing the goods, so what kind of opponent are you after next?
I let MTK do that, you know, Tyrone's already, he's off a leash right now. I like Tyrone, so I'll leave him a couple, give him a year or two. No money messing, I'll let Jamie deal with and MTK deal with that. They know, they have a plan for me over the next couple of years. I signed a 3 to 5 year contract with them, and I mean, they know what they have in plan, they have in store for me. What's going to happen will happen, and I'll just keep training with Danny straight back to the gym, and here we go.
Is the public nuisance face before I get Danny involved? Yeah,
woo!
Danny, can I get up you quickly? Yeah?
That is
good interviews. That is top man interviews. I know. Yeah. I've interviewed him all the time. Just come in closer. Yeah. Well, Danny, you've been singing his praises since day one.
Mm-hmm.
You just got an incredible opponent out there within a minute and a bit in the first round. Was that the game plan going in, being this coach?
Listen, I'm going to be dead truthfully. We've expected a tough 8 round tonight. He's a tough kid who's coming to win. You can see, you know, his record speaks for itself, but as I keep telling everyone, he's doing what I see week in, week out in the gym. He's bringing now into the ring what he's been doing in the gym. And this fella's going to go to the top, he really is. That was a fantastic performance. We've been working on the left, the uppercuts up the middle. He said, we'll try it early doors because the fella was wide open for it. He's through it the first time, the fella reacted, he was hurt off it. He's jumped on him like he was an all pro. It looked like he had about 30 fights. The finish was frightening. And he's coming on leaps and bounds.
He's got the killer instinct as well.
Well, he wouldn't let him off the hook, Andrew, and that's what I said. I said, as soon as he was on him, he wasn't letting him go. But just before that, he clipped him with a right hook and the fella looked hurt. Then he's put it up there and round the side again. Unreal performance, I'm absolutely made up with him.
Here's a question for you. I asked it on the same thing, but how do you match him then going forward? I mean, he's 7-0, 8-0?
7-0.
7-0? I know. He's 7-0, he's flying so far. I mean, his debut back in August, yeah. It's May, he's 7-0, he's doing everything right, doing everything you're asking of him, so yeah. How do you match him going forward? I mean, the super lightweight division, as well, we've all discussed before, is a stacked division, so how do you match him?
Listen, in my opinion, he's ready for them all. He really is, but he doesn't have to get pushed. As you said, he's only, he hasn't been pro for 12 months.
Not even 9 months.
Listen, you know, he's dismantled top professionals like that. You know, we've just got to pull the reins in a little bit. We're not ready. It's not the finished article, but, you know, it's a working process. So we're not just going to jump and just start calling everyone out. We're going to get back to the gym, keep doing what we're doing, and whoever MTK matches with next, that's who we'll fight.
Dan, you know I like people calling people out. Guess what gets me my views?
Well,
call somebody out.
You call someone out.
Call them out? No, I'll call Sam Maxwell. He's going to be European. I'll let Tom McKenna win the WBC silver and then we'll do it.
The good stuff. I don't think Dan will allow that.
The perfect venue is in the MTK Global Gym.
What's next from then? When's his next fight? When's he out next?
He'll be out in August, we think. On the big show. On the McConnell one. He'll be out there, yeah. Whether it's a title fight or not. But if it's the right one, we'll take it. He's ready to be let off the leash. I want to hold him back. Performances like that, it could be out of my hands.
Good stuff. Well, I spend a lot of time down the gym. I see how you work and all that, so it's very good to see the progress that you're making pay off in the ring. So, well done to you.
Well done. That's it. Bang, bang, gravy chip.
Bang, bang, gravy chip. There you go. You want to say bang, bang, gravy chip?
Bang, bang, gravy chip.
And his nuisance face. Can you do that face?
I can't do that.
Good stuff, guys. Thanks for this.
Thanks, Andrew. Appreciate it.